Happy May, everybody. I decided to do a video version of the newsletter this month instead of writing something, mainly because I've included a lot of content for you guys that I've been collecting for this last month that either touched me personally or something that I thought was really interesting or something I took information from. I have a podcast that I'm listening to that I love that I'm going to share, also a book, some articles on sleep, addiction, relationships, all kinds of good stuff. So I hope everyone's been doing okay this month, or at least the month of April. I know this is a new month now in May. This past month has just been so crazy for thousands and thousands of people. It's been a tough month for me as well. So many crazy things have been going on in my life. It's one of the reasons why I didn't have the newsletter last month. I just didn't really have it in my heart to produce anything. And I hope you understand. And it's one thing I actually wanted to talk to you guys about is that, you know, during this time, I'm an A personality. So anytime I have some downtime, even though I can be sort of a hippie and I like to meditate and I like quiet me time, anytime I find space where, oh my gosh, I have time, let's create something. Let's create content. Let's start a podcast. Let's write a book. Let's, you know, start a company or whatever. That's where my mind goes. But this month, this past month, I really made myself stop and say, let's just get quiet for a second. Instead of producing, which you can do down the road, let's just get quiet and see what happens. And it was tough. It was a little bit of a roller coaster for me. And I'm sure if you're like me or out there, you're either wanting to go volunteer or create something or change the entire house or write a book or whatever it is you know, on your brain, it's hard to turn that off, especially if you are used to creating. So I'm happy that I haven't been doing that. And it's been a little bit of a struggle, like I said, but the cool thing with any habit that we're changing, I think slowly, if we go into that space, slowly bring yourself back to, no, let's remind ourselves to be quiet. It's okay. Be quiet. So part of that for this month, for Be Kind & Co., which makes me really happy is that, and one of the reasons why I started Be Kind & Co. is because of things like this, when we have revelations of, oh, there's a little bit of self-care that I can give myself. There's a place where I can be kind to myself and not expect so much from me. I mean, I think about my friends who have kids and a husband and two dogs and a job, and during all this pandemic and homeschooling, I don't know how you're doing it, but so many of you out there are doing it. Or if you're taking care of your mom or your dad, or you're worried about your mom or your dad or your family, there's so many pressures on everyone and so much fear right now for everyone. So it's one other thing I did include in this newsletter as well, is dealing with anxiety and learning to deal with our fears. And even this really cool article that I included about what it actually really looks like in our body when we emote, I think that's the right word, emotions like depression or anger or shame or guilt or grief, whatever you're going through. It's very cool. It's a little bit of a dated article. It's back to 2015, but for some reason I'm very visual and I like seeing things like that, and hopefully you'll enjoy it too. I also included some articles on sleep and addiction. There's this podcast that I'm listening to by Boyd Vardy, who is in a treehouse in South Africa by himself for 40 days and 40 nights. And every single day he reports back about what's going on in nature while he is there alone in a tree with wild animals pretty much all around him. And imagine being out there in the quiet. And so the things that he shares are spectacular. Also, Glennon Doyle has written a book called Untamed, which is really speaking to me right now, all about women, family, children, societal definitions that society puts on us as children and as young adults, and even as we age, and depending on what relationships we're in or what careers we've chosen, it's really great. I just hope that eventually this is all going to move forward. You know, there's a lot of fear out there for a lot of us right now of the unknown. And that's another great thing about kindness, and about knowing that kindness is your strength and that kindness is not a weakness. That when we do know, we don't know about the known, we're fearful of the unknown, which by the way causes anxiety. That's when we can come back to ourselves and give ourselves self-care and self-love in quiet moments like meditation. Just like with me, not feeling like I have to produce or I have to go out there and do something constantly. Self-care is key when it comes to keeping our sanity. And so I hope you enjoy all the things that I've collected for you this month. I've got this random flower in my hand, but it's a part of a arrangement that some of my girlfriends sent to me. It was a huge box of sunflowers from three of my girlfriends who basically were sending me love and some good energy this past month. And I appreciate it so much. And these little guys are still alive. So, and I love wearing them in my hair. So it makes me happy. I hope you're happy. Happy May. And I look forward to hearing your responses. Anything you want to share with me, if there's something that you're doing in the community or that you know of people who are doing things in the community, tag us at Be Kind & Co. or tag me at Lou Parker LA on Instagram or Facebook, wherever. I'd love to hear everything. And we'd love to share some of that information too, out into the community. And I appreciate you being a part of our kindness tribe as well. It makes me very, very happy. Okay, see you guys later. Bye.